joints. Where will you record net profit or net loss?
Net profit on credit side. Net loss on debit side. Profit and loss on
debit side. Then where will you record capital balance?
Partners capital account
credit side, and where will we record debits? Debit side of partners capital account. In the beginning, we will record three things. One is net profit or net loss. Net profit P&L appropriation credit side, and net loss P&L appropriation debit side. Secondly, we will record capital balance partners capital account credit side. Thirdly, we will record drawings in partners capital account on debit side. After that, all the adjustments we will give to invoice. Now, Jite, which is the only adjustment which comes in P&L appropriation credit side and partners capital account debit side?
Interest on drawings.
All other adjustments will come in P&L appropriation account on debit side and partners capital account on credit side. Is everyone clear with this? Take out your notebooks. We'll take up with the second method tool, that is fixed capital method. What is going on? Yes, Khushi, what happened? Now listen everyone. Raise your hand. Why the earlier method was called as fluctuating capital method? Raise your hand. Why was the earlier method called as fluctuating capital method? No one of you know that? So just again, it's like that only fluctuating capital method. Now this is very disappointing. So listen carefully. Fluctuating capital method was called as fluctuating capital method because the capital amount will change every year. Opening balance of capital would not be same as closing balance because we make so many entries on the credit side as well as on the debit side. And it's compulsory that every one of you will write this reason 50 times by tomorrow. Because you people are not attentive in the class at all. Simple reason, not a single person of you could answer. Why fluctuating capital method, we call it as fluctuating capital? Did I not discuss this in the class in the last period? No. What now? Everything is recorded, I'll show it to you. After making the formats, I explained it to you. Now why is it fluctuating? So many entries are there on credit side, debit side, closing will not be same as opening. I discussed also, what do you mean by fluctuating? Changing. The capital keeps on changing every year, that's why we call it as fluctuating. How many times? 50 times write this reason and come. Fluctuating capital method is called fluctuating because the capital amount keeps on changing. 50 times compulsory for everyone. Okay? Now we are doing second method. What is that? Fixed capital method. What do you mean by fixed? Does not change. It will remain constant. Now the question arises, if we make so many entries on the credit side, and so many entries on the debit side, then how can the capital remain same? It can remain same only if we don't make any entry in capital account. Is it or not? When can the closing balance remain same as the opening balance? Only if we make no entries in capital account. That is what we will do here. Here we will make two accounts. One is partner's capital account and second is partner's current account. In capital account, we will record only opening balance, nothing else. So closing will remain same as opening balance. And all other entries we will record in the second account. Which account? Partner's current account. What is the name of second account? Current account. Current account means it records only adjustments related to current year. It does not record capital, which is brought in the past years. Because it records only current year's adjustment, it is called partner's current account. So here capital will remain fixed because all the adjustments will be made in which account? Partner's current account. Are you clear with the difference of the two? Next period if I ask, you'll be able to answer it, why fluctuating and why fixed? So why fluctuating is called fluctuating capital method? Because the capital amount keeps on changing, but you have to write 50 times. And why this is called fixed capital method? Because here capital amount will remain same, constant. And how will it remain same? Because all the adjustments will be done in partners. Anyone who did not understand this? So here we have to make two accounts, columnar form. 3 to 4 lines partners capital account and around 8 to 10 lines partners current account. If you remember in P&L appropriation, I told you leave one line on the debit side. So that was the reason that will come across today. Okay. So make the formats or specimens for two accounts. One is partners capital account and second is partners current account. 3 to 4 lines capital and 8 to 10 lines current account. Format will remain same. Why are you late?
I was in
the
bed.
So? So that's what is the reason? I didn't understand.
Actually, I was out with my dad.
So didn't you know the time is 5:15?
Yes.
Then?
Sorry.
You should not be late, otherwise I'll send you back for the next period. Come in. A and B partners,
yes.
In the beginning, so two columns will be made, A and B. Raise your hand who is still making the format. All have done it. Shall I proceed with its explanation? Now, just now I discussed with you, why would we call this method as fixed capital method? Because capital amount will remain same. And when will capital amount remain same? When no entry except opening balance of capital is done in partner's capital account. So only one thing will come in partner's capital account. On the credit side, opening balance by balance brought down. That's it. Only one thing will come on the credit side, opening balance by balance brought down. And that itself will become closing balance. Okay, that itself will become closing balance. Two balance carried down. Understood this? So, fixed capital method, because capital will remain same. No entries are made in capital account, so capital amount will remain same every year. Is everyone clear with this? All the other entries which earlier we used to make in partners capital account will now come in partners account. Now, beginning two to three things, put your pens down and understand it first. The list, all the points are same as capital account. The only thing is they are going to come now in current account. So that you can write along with me. But starting two to three points are new so that you understand first. Okay. First year of new business. When you make current account, it will have no opening balance. First year of a new partnership business. When you make current account, it will have no opening balance. Then in the first year, all those entries will record interest on capital, salary, bonus, commission, remuneration, net divisible profit, drawings, interest on drawings. So it will have some closing balance. That will become opening balance for next year. And this closing balance can be any balance. It could be credit balance, credit side more than debit side. Or it could be debit balance more than credit side. Because it depends whether interest on capital, bonus, etc. is more than your drawings, or drawings, interest on drawings is more than interest on capital, etc. So it could be debit side total also more, it could be credits and total also more. Generally when capital account we make it as a credit balance only, because capital itself is very huge amount which comes on the credit side. So credit side total would be generally more. But in current account there is no opening balance. So if debit side figures are more then it can be a debit balance. Credit side figures are more then it can be a credit balance. So very first thing what you will remember is current account can have any balance. It may have a debit balance or it may have a credit balance. It will be specified in the question. Is it a debit balance or is it a credit balance will be specified. Credit balance we will write on credit side and debit balance we will write on debit side. Understood that? So write down by balance brought down if it is credit balance. Okay. And debit side, two balance brought down. If it is debit balance. It is quite possible that one partner has a credit balance and another partner has a debit balance. A has made no drawings in the year. So his credit side figures will be more than debit side. He will have a credit balance. B has withdrawn huge amounts during the year. So his debit side will become more than credit side. He will have debit balance. So one partner may have credit balance and one partner may have debit balance. You just remember that. Credit balance we will write on credit side. Debit balance we will write on debit side. And then we will record drawings. Now, drawings will not be transferred to capital account. Drawings will be transferred to partner's current account because capitals are supposed to remain fixed, constant, same. So drawings will not be transferred to capital account. Drawings will be transferred to current account. Did everyone of you understand it? Current account debit side to drawings account. Understood that everyone? Any confusions? So when we solve questions on fluctuating capital method, in the beginning we record how many things?
Three
things. Now when we solve the question by fixed capital method, in the beginning you will record four things. What one extra thing comes?
Balance
of current account. Means now when we solve the questions in this method, in the beginning instead of three things we will record four. First you will record net profit or net loss in P&L appropriation account. Second you will record capital balance in capital account. Third you will record current account balance in current account. Credit balance, credit side. Debit balance,
debit side.
And fourth you will record drawings. Any confusion on this? So now when we solve the questions by fixed capital method, in the beginning we will record four things. First, net profit or net loss. Second, capital balance. Third, current accounts balance. And fourth, drawings. Any confusions in this? Now again put your pens down. Credit balance of current account will be considered similar to capital for the purpose of giving effects of interest on current account. For the purpose of giving interest on current account, credit balance of current account will be considered similar to capital. Means owner will take interest from the business. For the business it's an expense. Debit balance of current account will be considered similar to drawings for the purpose of giving effects of interest on current account. Means if current account is having debit balance, then owner will pay interest to the business. For the business, it's an income. So for the purpose of interest on current account, credit balance will be considered similar to
capital
balance. Debit balance will be considered similar to
drawings.
Okay. Now, what two effects did we give for interest on capital? What two effects did we give for interest on capital? Profit and loss appropriation account on debit side and partner's capital account on credit side. Same way you will give two effects of interest on current accounts credit balance. Profit and loss appropriation on debit side and partner's current account on
credit side.
That is why I made you leave that line over there. Take out that profit and loss appropriations format. Debit side where you have left two lines before net divisible profit. Have you left two lines before net divisible profit? There, write down two interest on current account in bracket credit balance and amount three crosses. Got it everyone? Second effect will come in partner's current account on credit side by interest on current account in bracket credit balance. Got it, everyone? I'll give you one shortcut also afterwards. But first, actual concept. Credit balance of current account will be considered similar to
capital.
Business will pay interest to the owner if current account is having credit balance. For the business, it is an
expense.
For the owner, it's an income. So, what two effects you'll get? P&L appropriation account,
debit side,
and partner's current account,
credit side.
And if current account is having debit balance, then its interest will be similar to interest on
drugs.
Owner will pay interest to the business. For business, it's an income. Where will it come in? P&L appropriation account?
Yes.
Credit side. Did everyone write this down?
Yes.
In P&L appropriation, right, credit side, by interest on current account, in bracket debit balance and three process. Okay, and here it will come on debit side to interest on current account in bracket debit balance. Did you understand this, everyone? Okay, now shortcut. Repeat. Interest on current account.
Interest on current account.
In partner's current account.
In partner's current account.
On same side.
On same side.
And in P&L appropriation account on opposite side.
And in P&L appropriation account on opposite side.
See, if current account is having credit balance, then its interest you'll write on the same side, credit side. P&L appropriation opposite side, debit side. If current account is having debit balance, then in current account you'll write its interest on the same side, debit side, and P&L appropriation account on opposite side,
credit side.
Understood that? So what is the shortcut for remembering the effects of interest on current account? Partner's current account?
Same side.
P&L appropriation account?
Opposite side.
One more time. Interest on current account will appear in partner's current account on
same
side. P&L appropriation account on
opposite side.
Any confusion in this? All other entries of partner's capital will be done in partner's current account. So that you can now do along with me. Which other entries were there on the credit side?
Interest on capital.
By interest on capital.
By
salary.
By bonus
or commission or remuneration. Any confusions in this? And which entries were there on the debit side? Only one entry was there, two interest on drawings. And instead of net divisible profit, if there is net divisible loss. Are you clear with this? Now, as I said, it does not have opening balance of capital, which is basically a huge amount. So which side total will be more? Any side total can be more. Means it can have credit balance or debit balance. Practically, when we do the balancing, you have to look at the amounts on both the sides. If you feel that debit side amounts look more, then do debit side total first and balance will come on credit side. That's a debit balance, because debit side total is more. If you feel credit side figures are bigger, then you do credit side total first and whatever amount remains on the debit side closing balance, that would be a credit balance because credit side total is more. Got it, everyone? And it's quite possible, it will be possible in fact in few questions, where one of the partners credit side will be more and one of the partners debit side will be more. Is everyone clear with it? So if credit side is more, then credit balance that will appear on debit side, two balance carried down. But then it is which balance which appears on debit side? Credit balance. Credit side total is more. And if debit side total is more, then it will come on credit side by balance carried down. It appears on credit side, but it is which balance? Debit balance, because debit side total is again one partner will have any one balance only. Yes, it's quite possible that one partner has a credit balance and the other has a debit balance. Is everyone clear with this? So this is how we make the accounts in fixed capital method. Okay? What is fluctuating capital method? Capital amount keeps on
changing.
Why capital amount keeps on changing? So many entries are done in capital accounts, so closing balance will not be same as opening balance. Fixed capital method means capital amount will remain same. Why capital amount will remain same? No entries are done in capital accounts, so closing will remain same as opening balance. All entries are done in partners. Are you all clear with this question, everyone? Now, how will we solve these questions? As I said in the beginning, we will record four things. First, net profit or net loss in P&L appropriation account. Second, capital balance in partners capital account. Third, current accounts balance, credit balance, credit side, debit balance,
debit side.
Fourth, amounts. And then all the adjustments you will give?
Two years.
Now two shortcuts you will remember. First, in all the adjustments, interest on drawings is the only thing which comes in P&L appropriation on? Credit side. Partners current account on?
Debit side.
Second shortcut, interest on current account will come in partner's current account on
same
side and P&L appropriation account on
opposite side.
Everything is P&L appropriation debit side, partner's current account
credit side.
Any confusion in this? This is how we will solve the long questions. But first long question will take 40 to 45 minutes to solve. So that will solve in the next period. In the homework, you will be writing this format and number. Blueprints of 12th standard have come, book paper pattern in Gujarati language. So I have made some efforts to understand it in English, what is it exactly. And it is known that from this chapter, we are going to have short questions for 2 or 3 marks weightage. Short question means your exercise question number 3 if you see. Your exercise question number 3 and first 11 illustrations. Exercise question number 3 is full of short questions, you can see that. Around 11 or 12 are there?
11.
And first 11 illustrations are also there, they are also objective ones. So what we shall be doing is, this way whatever time remains, we will use it in solving those short questions which are actually going to come in your board exams. This what we are practicing will not come directly in board exams, but indirectly it will help you in the second chapter. That is final accounts. Because when we solve the question of final accounts, we have to make trading, P&L appropriation, partner's capital, balance sheet. Again in partner's capital, if in trial balance, current account balance is given, means you have to make these two accounts. So whatever long questions we are solving in this chapter will help us in final accounts. And whatever short questions we do in this chapter will directly come in your board exams. Is everyone clear with it? So one of the short questions concept I'll explain you today. Okay, understand it completely. You just have to understand it's a concept, you don't have to write anything. At the end I'll be making you write one note only. So just close your notebooks, put your pens down, relax, just be attentive. Let us say that there are two partners in our business. Shrushti and Parikh. Two partners in the business. Hope the business runs well. Shrushti and Parikh. Now, Shrushti withdraws 1,000. Withdraws means? Drugs. 1,000 every month. Shrushti withdraws 1,000 every month at the beginning. Means, what is the starting of the year? She withdraws 1,000 on 1st April, then 1st May. Again 1,000 on 1st June, again 1,000 on 1st July, up till 1st March. Every month, she withdraws 1,000 at the beginning. And Parikh, her partner, she also withdraws, he also, she also, whatever, 1,000 per month, but at the end. Means Parikh withdraws 1,000 on 30th April, then 30th May, then 1st June, Shrushti will withdraw. Then 30th June, Parikh will withdraw, then 1st July again, Shrushti will withdraw. How is the business done, we don't know. But Shrushti withdraws 1,000 every month at the beginning, and Parikh withdraws 1,000 every month at the end. Now, calculating interest is so complicated, because for both of them, we have to do 12 calculations of interest. Understand it. Shrushti will withdraw on 1st April, then
1st
May, then 1st June, July, August, September, October, November, December, January, February, March. Now, whatever she withdraws on 1st April, for what period will you count interest from that? Full year, 12 months. If she withdraws on 1st May, you count interest for how many months?
11
months. That's it. Last is one. Okay. So 1st July you count for 9 months, then 8 months, then 7 months, 6 months, 5 months, 4 months, 3 months, 2 months and 1 month. Any confusion in this?
No.
Suppose the rate of interest is 12%. Suppose the rate of interest is 12%. We have to make 12 calculations. First calculation, 1000 into 12% into 12 by 12, that is full year. Then second calculation, 1000 into 12% into 11 by 12. Then 1000 into 12% into 10 by 12. 1000 into 12% into 9 by 12. 1000 into 12% into 8 by 12, 1000 into 12% into 7 by 12, 1000 into 12% into 6 by 12, 1000 into 12% into 5 by 12, 1000 into 12% into 4 by 12, 1000 into 12% into 3 by 12. 1000 into 12% into 2 by 12. And 1000 into 12% into 1 by 12. So many calculations. Is it or not?
Yes.
Now, 1000 into 12% into 12 by 12 is 120.
Yes.
Then 1000 into 12% into 11 by 10 is 110. Count it. 1000 into 12% into 11 by 12. 10 by 12 is 100. 9 by 12 is 90. 8 by 12 is 80. 7 by 12 is 70. 60. 50. 40. 20. 20. Any confusion in this?
No.
Now, 120, 230, 330, 420, 500, 570, 630, 680, 720, 750, 770, 780. What is the total interest on drawings? 780. Now in this, we put some mathematical knowledge. And for the first time, maths makes the things simple for you. Okay, we put some mathematical knowledge and it will make the things simple. What is common in all the calculations?
12%
divide by 12 is also common. This portion, is it common in all the calculations or not?
Yes.
Everywhere we have 1000 into 12%. Everywhere we have divided by 12. So that we write only one time. 1000 into 12% divided by 12. This is common. Now what is uncommon? The number of months. So that you add it and multiply it one time only. 12 plus 11? 23. 23 plus 10? 33 plus 9, 42 plus 8, 50 plus 7, 57 plus 6, 63, 68, 72, 75, 77, 78. You add the number of months. What are the total number of months coming to? 78. You multiply it at one time only. Count it. 1000 into 12% into 78 divided by 12. See the magic. Is it or not? So, this will come in your long questions. And we will not calculate 12 times. We will calculate only one time. And you will now remember it as learn by heart. That if any person withdraws the money at the beginning of any month, directly count interest on interest for 78 months. Is everyone clear with this? Further, now do I need to explain you in detail for end?
No.
I'll directly explain you how many months. Instead of 1st April, you'll withdraw the money on
30th
April then.
31st
May then.
30th June.
31st
July.
31st August. 30th September. 31st October. 30th November. 31st December. 31st January. Suppose 28th February and 31st March. Is everyone clear with this? Now tell me, if you withdraw the money on 30th April, then you will count interest for how many months?
11
months, because 1 month is over. If you withdraw the money on 30th April, you will count interest from May to March. So May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December, January, February, March. How many months?
11
months. Here you withdraw on? So all 12 months. Here you withdraw on? 30th April, so 11 months. So 31st May, how many months?
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
31st March, if you withdraw any money, no interest. Because you are withdrawing on the last day of the year, you are not using any money in that year, but basically. So, 11 to 0, did you understand it? No need to add it again. 11 to 0 means this total?
66.
So, 78 minus 12?
66.
66. Means, how would you count this interest per parikh? 1000 into 12% into 66 divided by 12. 660. So you will remember it as a note that if any partner withdraws money at the beginning of every month, interest will be calculated for 78 months. If any partner withdraws the money at the end of every month, interest will be calculated for 66 months. And how did we get 78 and 66 all up here?
Yes.
And why mathematically for 78 and 66 months? Because 1000 is
common.
12% is
common.
Divide by 12 is
common.
What is uncommon is only
number
of months that we add. If you withdraw in the beginning of every month, then the summation of number of months comes to
78.
If you withdraw at the end of every month, then the summation of number of months comes to
66.
And if you withdraw in the middle of every month, average of 72, 78 and 66 average. 78 plus 66 divided by 2?
72.
Otherwise, 15th April what you withdraw, you count interest for 11 and a half months. 15th May?
10 and a half months.
15th June?
9 and a half months.
15th March? Only half month. 15th March only half months. Do 11.5 plus 10.5 plus 9.5 plus 8.5 plus 7.5 plus 6.5 plus 5.5 plus 4.5 plus 3.5 plus 2.5 plus 1.5 plus 0.5. 72. Does it come or not?
Yes.
So any concept asked, this is the basic point. Add the number of months and directly count it for that many months. But in your textbook, we have discussed only 2 points, beginning and
ending.
Got it, everyone? So write down as a note. And this comes in short questions for 2 or 3 marks also. If any partner, note one, if any partner, one more thing, just 1 minute. One more thing, it is important. If Shrushti has withdrawn 1000 every month, what is the total amount you have withdrawn in the whole year? 12,000. 1000, 1000. 12 months you have withdrawn how much amount?
12,000.
Annual drawings is 12,000, but we don't count interest on 12,000. We count on 1000. So remember this, when we go to final accounts chapter, you make a mistake. In this chapter, you will not make a mistake. Because in final accounts, in trial balance, 12,000 will be given, total drawings. But we don't have to count interest on annual drawings. We have to count it on
monthly
amount of drawings. Because what is common everywhere is not annual amount, it is the
monthly.
So this is an important point, remember this. You will count interest on
monthly
amount and not on
annual
amount. In final accounts, definitely you will make a mistake. Because there in trial balance will be directly given with 12,000. So interest is to be calculated on
monthly
amount, not on
annual amount.
Okay. Now, note one. If any partner withdraws same amount at the beginning of every month, then interest will be calculated on, in capital letters, right, monthly amount for the period of 78 months. Underline beginning, underline 78 months. Copy down the same note for end on your own. Beginning will be replaced with? 78 will be replaced with? 66. Remaining language will remain?
Same.
So copy down the same note on your own. Note 2. Monthly word write in capital letters, monthly amount word, and at the end underline end at 66 months. Shall I erase this? Anyone who did not understand the concept, why 78 months or why 66 months? All are clear with this? Shall I erase it? So, any confusions? Page 30, exercise 3, question 1. Page 30, exercise 3, question 1. Did you all take it out? Withdraws and then identical. This is also necessary. When you withdraw same amount every month, then only that 1000 will come in the common factor. Then only it will come as common in all the numbers. So a partner withdraws identical amount at the, circle the word end of each month from the firm. How many months?
66
months. End means 66. At the end of the year, total unlined annual drawings is rupees 12,000. Will we count interest on 12,000?
No.
On which amount?
1,000.
We have to count interest on monthly amount. Okay, annual 12,000. So 12,000 divided by 12. What will be the monthly amount?
1,000.
12% per annum interest is chargeable on drawings. Determine the interest on drawings for the year. Same what we did. 780. 660, end of the month. So, write down. First, write down the nonsense. It's a 2-mark question, so one note it deserves. Since the partner has withdrawn the amount at the end of each month, comma interest will be calculated. Comma interest will be calculated for 66 months. Below that, therefore interest on drawings is equal to 1000 into 12% into 66 divided by 12. 660. Any confusion in this? All are clear with it? Look at question number 4. So all of you are clear with this point? Question number 4. The profit and loss sharing ratio of Rajkumar, Kaushik and Sharma is 15:10:9. Raise your hand. What do you mean by 15:10:9? Parikh?
Rajkumar will get 15/34 of profit, Kaushik will get 10/34 of profit, and Sharma will get 9/34
of profit. Yes, do 15+10+9 everyone. 15+10+9 is 34. So what do you mean by 15:10:9? Rajkumar will get 15/34, Kaushik will get 10/34, and Sharma will get 9/34. The total profit of the year of the firm is rupees 68,000. Determine the share in profit of each partner. So 68,000 into 15/34, 68,000 into 10/34, and 68,000 into 9/34. Right, everyone?
Yes.
Let us show the distribution. Question 4. Profit is how much? 68,000. We have to distribute it between three partners: Rajkumar, Kaushik, and Sharma. Okay, the ratio is 15:10:9. 15 + 10? 25 + 9 = 34. So 15/34, 10/34, 9/34. So what is the share in profit of each partner? 68,000 into 15/34. 30,000. 68,000 into 10/34. 20,000. 68,000 into 9/34. 18,000. 2 short questions, everyone. So this way, every period, if after solving the long question time remains, we'll take one of the short questions. Otherwise, after all the long questions are over, then remaining short questions will take at one. Okay, presently, based on these, you can take in homework illustration 1. And in illustration 1, explanation is given as I did in the board. How did you get that 78 and 66? You don't have to write the explanation. You directly have to write this 66/12 and 78/12 only. Okay? So illustration 1 is your homework. That's it. Only illustration 1 is your homework. Plus, you have to make this formats. And without seeing it. Write these 2 formats in homework notebook without seeing it, so that when we start in the practical questions in the next period, we are able to understand which entries will come on inside. By the way, how will we solve the things now? First, we will record net profit or net loss, capital balance, current account balance, credit. credit balance, credit side, debit balance, debit side. Drawings. Signal effect, these four things. Then all the adjustments? Two effects. In that, two shortcuts. First, interest on drawings. P&L appropriation. Credit side, partner's current account, debit side. Only thing. Interest on current account, partner's current account. Same side, P&L appropriation account, opposite side. Everything else. P&L appropriation, debit side, partner's current account,
debit side.
Okay, so that is how we'll solve the next long questions in the next period. Statistics will take up 5 minutes.